A warm welcome to the viewers of Beyond Classroom YouTube channel. This is Mr. Shovik Ghosh and I'm going to explain you the topic digital marketing in this video. Let's start with the concept of market first. Market is a location where potential buyers and sellers meet directly and indirectly to trade goods and services for value. Examples of physical form of markets include departmental stores, shopping malls, etc. And that of digital market includes online platforms, means the e-commerce platforms which we use for online shopping. Now, marketing is a process which includes promoting of goods and services for the purpose of selling, and it includes market research and advertising. Now, there is not much difference between digital marketing and physical form of marketing. The main difference is that digital marketing uses online marketing channels to promote the goods and services for the purpose of selling. That is it uses digital environment. Example, I request the viewers of the platform to like, share and comment on the video if they like it. So here the digital channel used is YouTube. This is also a form of digital marketing. Now, with an increased use of internet, the opportunity of digital marketing has increased worldwide. In the era of marketing 4.0, the combined use of online and offline marketing are expected to increase interactions between businesses and customers. Now, why should we use online marketing or digital marketing? It is cost effective, first of all. It is time saving and it helps in marketing goods and services globally. Besides this, it is available 24/7 and also helps in brand building. Digital marketing enhances market segmentation. So there are several other benefits and I am not going into the details in this video. Let us discuss the disadvantages of using digital marketing. First of all, there are security and privacy issues. For example, if a website is hacked, then there is every possibility of posting garbage information to hamper the goodwill of that particular company or organization. Now, with the increased use of digital marketing, there may be some benefits, but at the same time, disadvantages like negative opinions can also crush the goodwill of the marketers or a particular company. For example, if there is any negative comment on a particular product or service or any particular company, it spreads like wildfire and may destroy the goodwill of a company. That is why online customer service should be handled carefully. Besides this, a huge maintenance cost is required for digital marketing because every day the technology world is changing and the online marketing company requires to train their employees and upgrade their skills. For that, they have to bear certain costs. Now, coming to the digital marketing channels, first of all, we come to mobile platforms. We know that web-based applications are in regular usage. We use almost regularly for 2 to 3 hours in minimum, and that is why it has attracted many digital marketers for launching their products and services or for promoting their products and services using this platform. Example, Flipkart, Amazon, etc. Now, display ads are also used to efficiently communicate the target audience using videos to infographics. Now, here the companies have to pay per click. Now, we come to search engine marketing. These are paid searches, and obviously the preference is high compared to the free searches. We find this kind of paid searches at the top of the web pages. That is, they are having a higher ranking compared to the free searches. Here, the cost per click is high, but instead of that, the return on investment is also satisfactory, which is around 100%. Coming to free searches, that is search engine optimization. These are always placed below the paid searches, and the preference is comparatively lower, obviously. But there are chances of increasing visibility of this kind of ads by improvising certain new techniques, like creating linkable contents or keyword research, etc. Now, social media has always been an important medium for marketing, rather to say digital marketing. It helps in better understanding the needs and interests of the users. That is why it has become one of the important digital marketing channels. Example, Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, LinkedIn, etc. Now, coming to emails. With an expected increase in the number of email users from 3.9 billion in 2020 to 4.3 billion in 2023, it is expected to automatize content marketing as well as personalize those content marketing. Now, coming to websites. Websites are very necessary parts of digital marketing channels, which are used for providing a digital presence of the companies in the internet world. Websites use multimedia applications to disseminate several vital information to the probable customers regarding its products and services. Now, let me explain you a few examples which are practically implemented in the past few years. Like Mahindra and Mahindra first used its digital marketing campaigns while launching one of its prestigious products, sports utility vehicle XUV500 in 2011. Over the last 3 years, it had spent almost 60 crore rupee for digital marketing. Similarly, Hyundai had also started digital marketing for the purpose of penetrating more and more in the small towns and rural areas. In the financial sector, banks, insurance, and financial companies also use digital marketing extensively. An example, SBI launched its digital marketing campaign, hashtag Cash Ki Adat Badlo. This was to promote SBI debit cards, SBI Pay, SBI digital wallets, etc. Also, the extensive use of artificial intelligence and machine learning in this era of Industry 4.0 has increased the importance of chatbots. HDFC has its own chatbot OnChat. Similarly, City Union Bank has its own humanoid Lakshmi. Like this, several other financial institutions are using chatbots. I would like to conclude the video by citing two more examples, rather two more incidents or events which has taken place very recently and are expected to change the digital marketing world or digital marketing scenario in the coming years in India. First one is the purchase of 9.99% stake of Facebook in Reliance Jio, and the second one is purchase of 1.15% stake of Reliance Jio by an American private equity firm. The name is Silver Lake. Both of these deals are expected to enhance the digital marketing experience in the coming years. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.